Welcome to another theory video. This video is on CAPE IT Unit 1. I hope you learned something.
Alright, so manual information. The goal of manual information processing would be to manual information processing requires humans, right, to manage the process throughout its existence, obtaining it into information. So when you have a human deciding or determining that the information is going to go through, that's what manual implies. So they use a lot of non-technological tools. Non-technological tools would be like people filling out forms, you group the data, you extract something from the data with your eyes, you represent the information in relevant forms, which would be like on a Bristol board or some kind of thing like that. And then you distribute the findings to people, which is kind of plenty lame. Sort of, kind of. So a manual example would be students fill out a form about sourcing, like the forms are grouped into specific year groups. Then somebody will pull out the most popular sport in each group, and then they will put it on a chart and they'll present it to the PTA. That will take kind of long because somebody had to actually read through all of the forms to find the information that you need. Automatic now would be using a computer or computer systems to remove the human interaction or remove the human problem that would happen, which, like, humans will definitely make mistakes because let's say that somebody in the process of grouping it, they group people who play football, people who play cricket or something, anything like that. That would be a problem, so you don't want that to happen. You kind of want to make sure that your process is without fault, yeah. So, automated information processing is using hardware, software, networks, and users to automatically capture and process the information. So, with the humans, they would have to work hard to capture it and all that stuff. With the computer, you don't have to work too hard. So, the types of information information systems you could have would be a transaction processing system. The ones in the syllabus would be TPS, DSS, MIS, EIS, and expert system. All these others, they kinda exist. I can't remember if they list all of them in the syllabus. Let me check. Nah, they didn't. In module 2, I think they listed out. Yeah, module 2, I think they listed out. So we just continue with these. Alright, so in automated, you will input the information, which will be like data capture, which will be OCR, OMR. Process, they will use the computer to analyze it, to do mathematical calculations. Then the data would be stored and analyzed if necessary and retrieved. Storage and retrieval, kind of one and the same, kind of. Then they will have an output, which will be presenting the data or information. And they will send it to the stakeholders. Right, input is both data capture and data entry. So sometimes the user could put in the information, but when the information, they have to do validation and verification. Because the data entry is a problem, because there's an actual human doing it now. And then data capture would be like if you're scanning things from like a passport or scanning things from like a barcode reader. Barcode reader would be data capture. So the data could be captured using sensors, it could be on forms, it could be audio, it could be anything. And data entry is, you get it into the computer. The whole point of input is to get it into the computer, so you don't have to do the data collection from the manual process. And then tools using the input phase. Well, you could use a keyboard to type stuff. You could use a mouse. You could scan a barcode. You could use a OCR or MRI. All those things are sensors. All those things will get the information into. And once you get the information into it, then you could go through the process. Process now is going to allow you to organize the data. But the computer will do it. So the computer will do the organization and contextualizing with formulas. And this will replace the analysis in manual. So the tools used for the process: searching, sorting, calculations, averages, totals, minimums, maximums, counts, tabulating, deducing trends, data mining, summarizing. All those things are different ways that you could process in the exam.
Thanks for watching the theory video. If you learned something, give it a like, give it a share, subscribe, do whatever you have to do. And if you want practical applications of the things, feel free to check out any of my classes. You can find them on my website at makeitsimplett.com. I have classes for all different subjects from CSEC IT, CAPE IT, CAPE Computer Science, and many different tutorial videos that you could find on this channel. So, thank you very much, and look out for the next video that is here or here, because I have all the theory videos for all the subjects.